Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering the top 300 most important MCQs of Indian Evidence Act 1872. This is the third part of this video series. So in this video we cover question number 51 to question number 75. So start here, question number 51. Question number 51. The person who can make admission are mentioned in. So, section 17 mentions the definition of admission. So, in this question, the question asked to us person who. So, option D is correct. Section 18 is mentioned the person who makes an admission are mentioned. Question number 752. The admission by agents are admissible in civil proceeding under all circumstances. Admissible in civil proceeding only if the agent has authority to make admission. Never admissible in criminal proceeding, both P and C. So here answer is D. Both B and C are correct. Admissible in civil proceeding only if the agent has the authority to make admission, and never admissible in criminal proceeding. So it is the admission made by agent. Question number 53. The admission made by a party are evidence against. So privies in blood, privies in law, privies in state, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. Question number 54. Which of the following admission is no evidence? In admission by one of the several defendant in a suit against another defendant. In admission by a guardian ad litem against a minor. In admission by a one of a partners of a firm against and a firm or other partners. Option D, only A and B. So here answer is D. Only A and B are correct. And which of the following admission is no admission? So admission by the guardian ad litem against minor is not admission. And admission by a person by one of a partner of firm against the firm or other partners, so it is not admission. Question number 55. When a liability of a person and who is one of a parties and to a suit depend upon the liability to a stranger to a suit, when a admissible admission by the stranger in respect of his liability shall be an admission on a part of that person and who is a party to the suit, if it has been so provided. So it is clear here. Option C is section 19 of Indian Evidence Act. So section 19 mentions the admission by a person whose position must be proved as against party to suit. Question number 56. In reference made over a dispute matter to a third person, the declaration so made by that person shall be an evidence against the party. And making a reference by virtue of section 17, section 19, section 20 and section 21. So here answer is section 20. Option C is correct. Section 20 is very important here. So it is made by admission by a person expressly referred to by a party in to suit. So here main important word is expressly referred person in section 20. So that expressly referred person is third person. Question number 57. The communication made without prejudice are protected. So option D is here. Answer section 23 of Indian Evidence Act. The communication made without prejudice. Question number 58. The confession caused by inducement. This very key, important keyword, inducement, threat or promise is contained in section 24, 25, 26, 27. So here answer is section 24. So section 24 provide the provision, and if confession is made and during inducement, threat or promise, such confession is irrelevant. And if the inducement, threat or promise given by the person in authority. Section 20, question number 59. Section 24 of Evidence Act apply when the inducement, threat or promise come from a person in authority. These three words is very important. And person in authority. When the inducement is of a temporal kind. Temporal kind. When the inducement is a spiritual or a religious. A and B are correct. So here answer is 59 D. So if the inducement, threat or promise given by or come from a person in authority, and such inducement, threat or promise in temporal nature. Temporal means in worldly nature. So option D is correct, both A and B. Question number 60. Confession made to a police officer is inadmissible under section 24, 25, 26, 27. So here option B is correct. The confession made to a police officer inadmissible under section 25. Question number 61. A confession to be inadmissible under section 25 of Evidence Act must be related to a same crime for which he is charged, must be related to another crime. May be related to a same crime or another crime, and only A is correct and B is incorrect. So here option C is may be related to a same crime or another crime. Question number 62. Which of the following is not given by a section 25 of Evidence Act? Confession. Option A, confession made to a custom officer, confession made to a member of Railway Protection Force, and confession made to an officer under FARA Act, and all of the above. So here option D is correct, all of the above. Not given by a section 25 of Indian Evidence Act. Question number 63. A retracted confession can be made solely on the basis of confession, cannot be made solely the basis of conviction under any circumstance, cannot be made solely the basis of conviction unless the same is corroborate, both A and C are correct. So here answer C is correct, cannot be made solely the basis of conviction unless the same is corroborated. Question number 64. The confession made by a person while in police custody. police custody is inadmissible as. So here option B is correct, 26 section. The 26 section provide the provision, the confession by accused while in police custody and not to be proved against him, but if the immediate presence of magistrate, so in that time such confession is relevant, it become relevant. Question number 65. A confession made and while a police custody is admissible under section 26 of Evidence Act. So I previously expressed this, when the confession in police custody is become irrelevant due to the inducement, threat or promise, but if in person in authority, but when the magistrate is immediate presence in the police custody, in such time a given confession by the person is become relevant. So here option, if the made the presence of doctor, no, it is wrong here. The presence in the captain of the vessel, wrong here. The made in the presence of magistrate, yes, option C is correct here. Section 27 control, section 24 of Evidence Act, section 25 of Evidence Act, section 26 of Evidence Act, all of the above. So here all of the above, the section 27 is control all of the above sections. So in this section it is very important section to collecting the evidence for the police, and this section provide some special provision like how much of information received from accused may be proved. So in this section provide the information should be given by the accused and find out the facts, and one of the such things on shall be are related to the fact of relevant fact or fact in issue and the discovery of fact, and these are discovery of fact and by the and related to the admission or confession of the person or accused. So these things are mentioned in section 27 and it control all these three sections. Question number 67. Section 27 apply discovery of some fact which the police had not previously learned from other source and was first derived from information given by the accused. A discovery of some fact and which the police had previously learned from other source. Discovery of some fact and which the police had previously learned from other source and the accused has also given information regarding the same and all of the above. So here answer is option A, discovery of some fact which the police had not previously learned from other source was first derived from the information given by the accused. Section 27 belong to this provision. Question number 68. Indian section 27 of Evidence Act, discovery of fact include the object found, the place from where it is produced, both A and B, neither A and B. So here answer is C, both A and B, means object found and a place from where it is produced. Section 69, question number 69, section 27 of Evidence Act apply when a person given information is an accused but not in police custody. When a person given information is a accused and is a police custody. When a person is in police custody but not an accused. When a person is neither in police custody nor an accused. So here answer is B correct. When a person is given information, is an accused and in a police custody, the section 27, so when a person given information is an accused. Question number 27. Question number 1770 and under section 27 Indian Evidence Act, the whole statement is admissible. Only that portion of or that portion which distinctly relate to a discovery is admissible. Both are admissible depending on the facts and circumstance of this case. Only A and not B. So here answer is B. Only that portion which distinct relate to discovery is admissible. The fact discovered in a consequence of a joint information. So are not admissible and cannot be used against any of the accused person. So your answer is correct, option A. So the fact discovered in consequence of a joint information are not admissible and not to be used against any of the accused person. Confession of an accused is admissible another against and to the other co-accused. So here answer is C under section 30 of Indian Evidence Act. So section 30 provide that the consideration of approved confession affecting a person making it and other jointly trial for a same offense. So this section is very important because it provides the provision of joint trial. Joint trial. So section 30. There is very important case in this section related Bhuvani Sahu versus Emperor in 1949 Privy Council. So the admission or confession, the confession of a person who is joint trial is not very much relevant because of there is no oath, there is no cross-examination and such type of witness is unworthy witness. Question number 73. The confession one accused is admissible and against co-accused. If they are tried jointly for a same offense, if they are tried jointly from a different offense, if they are tried for a same offense but not jointly, if they are tried for a different offense and not jointly. So option A is correct here. If they are trial jointly, this keyword is very important, and for same offense. Question number 74. The confession of co-accused not required to on oath and cannot be tested by cross-examination. Option 1 here is point 1 here is no evidence within the meaning of section 3 of Evidence Act and cannot be a foundation of conviction, and on option point 2 the only limited use and which can be made of a confession of co-accused and is by the way of furnishing an additional reason for believing a such other evidence as exist. Point 3, it is a very weak type of evidence and is much weaker even than the evidence of an approver. So here answer option A is correct, both 1, 2 and 3 statements. So no evidence within the meaning of section 3, most important things. The co-accused, by the way of additional reason and believing that the other evidence means corroborate to other evidence, and such type of confession given by the co-accused is a weak type of evidence and much weaker and evidence of an approver. So option A is correct. Question number 75. The necessity rule as the admissibility of Evidence Act is contained in Section 31 of Evidence Act, 31 of Evidence Act, 32 of Evidence Act, 60 of Evidence Act, and 61 of Evidence Act. So here option B is correct. Section 32 of Evidence Act is provide the rule of necessity. So necessity, why, what is the rule of necessity? If there is no other chance and there is no opportunity, so those persons who are dead or cannot be found, and it is the out of the coverage of the court's jurisdiction and not possible without expending more and more money or wealth, so this is, they use the secondary type of evidence here, and that is the reason here this rule is applicable, rule of necessity. So option B is correct here, section 32. Thank you friends, today's